to, it allows to pay for advertising as opposed to Instagram and Facebook. So like I was saying before, an integral tool to our strategy is this tool called Chat Fuel. And this is a virtual assistant that uses artificial intelligence to automatically and dynamically respond to likes, comments, shares on our Facebook page, and more importantly, segment customers into groups. In our marketing, in our digital marketing strategy, we're gonna be targeting to customers, but we may reach decision makers such as chefs and purchasers. And so this chatbot will allow us to capture that engagement so we can further use their contact info for further lead generation. So here we have Lumen 5. This is a tool that uses artificial intelligence and machine learning that parses text, such as an article about oysters, and immediately turns it into a video post. And so this is a way to quickly generate video posts for a content strategy. And lastly, we have Google AdWords. Here's a post from when we Google searched the phrase Florida oysters, and Panacea did not show up in the first web page, and also these links are very out of date. And so the opportunity here is that we want to use content marketing, creating articles about oysters and the oyster industry to help naturally boost Panacea's web page ranking. And so that whole entire strategy, the whole aim was to automate the marketing, the digital marketing strategy. So now we have the budget. So we have a 90-day marketing budget. And how we came up with this number is essentially we took 90 days of sales and took a conservative estimate of 12% of sales, which is a conventional benchmark for estimating your marketing budget. So this is how much budget we have to work with. And so here we have our paid advertising metrics. And we want to look at should we advertise and what are the metrics associated with that. And so we have the customer lifetime value. Customer lifetime value is how much revenue a customer generates over the life of the business. And that's $469,000. We have cost of acquiring a customer. And this is plain stated, the cost to reach a customer, to onboard a customer, $154,000. And then lastly, we have cost per impressions. So essentially stating that we can afford to pay no more than $968 per 1,000 social media ad impressions. Now we have our metric components that were derived that helped us come to those numbers. And so essentially with our customer lifetime value, we assumed a 6.22 churn rate, which is the B2B average. And then for our cost per impressions, we looked at the average click-through rate for all social media campaigns across all industries. And this was average of 0.5%. And so this essentially tells us that we need 160,000 impressions to capture one client. And so now we segue into our costs. We estimate the cost for our entire strategy to be $964 across a 3-month campaign.
Okay, so here we have our marketing tool costs. First tool we have is Facebook Ads. The cost is variable. Hootsuite, that cost is free. Articulo, we have $19 equals 10 articles, $29 a month equals 30 articles. Lumen 5 is $100 a month. Chat Fuel is $30 a month, which equals $447 for our campaign period.
So here we have a example of our Facebook Ad Manager. And this helped us derive how much we should pay for Facebook ad management. So we said our objective is to reach 3 clients. The reason why we chose 3 clients is because we operate within a 3-month time frame, and we know it takes a significant amount of time to onboard new distributors. And so like we stated before, we need 160,000 impressions to reach to acquire one client. And in order to reach those cost per impressions across 3 customers, we need to average 6,400 impressions per day. And so in order to achieve that number in the Facebook Ad Manager, this will cost us $5.75 per day. And now we have our projected financials. So the entire 3-month initiative will yield $87,600 with an ROI of 90%. And so here's how we came to that number. So we know that Panacea Oyster pays 2 cents per oyster and retails that at 75 cents per oyster. That gives us a gross margin of 73 cents. We know that Panacea is averaging 10,000 units per week per customer, or per client, I should say. And so that yields a 29,000 monthly revenue per client. And so, like we stated before, we intend on acquiring 3 clients. And so those efforts will yield a monthly cash flow of $87,600 in revenue, which will give us an ROI of 90%. And so lastly, our projected lifetime value, we estimate will yield us $1.4 million. And so how we came to this valuation is that we took the customer lifetime value and we multiplied that times 3 clients, which yield us that revenue number. And so what we're saying here is that from our 3-month initiative, over the lifetime of the business, this 90-day initiative will have brought to the business $1.4 million in revenue over the business life.
Okay, so in regards to potential risks that Panacea can be exposed to, basically they can be exposed to oyster regulation as well as Facebook, which went under intense scrutiny because of its data, basically its data information being misused for its customer base by Cambridge University.
And also another risk that we found is the improper management of the social media accounts. If the social media accounts aren't kept up to date, it can drastically reduce the effectiveness of social media.
Okay, so to deal with the issue with as far as Panacea not having someone to basically work their social media, they can basically hire an intern from a university and integrate them into the overall social media system. And in regards to oyster regulation, they can hedge for the future and basically maintain their operations to deal with that regulation. As far as Facebook going down, they could just move to another social media platform to basically boost their brand awareness. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.